Hello everyone, so this is a continued session of natural language processing. Here I am going to start a data processing. As we know, in the previous session of NLP we have discussed few other things about natural language processing, like its definition, its detail, its features, its applications. It's all about chatbot and different types of chatbot, then two types of languages for which on which computer need to deal or which machine need to deal while understanding human language and natural language. What are these two languages? Computer language and natural language. Then what are the complexities and difficulties of natural language which machine can face while dealing with them or while understanding and processing the natural languages? So what we need to do to make the machines understand those natural languages, we need to process the data. So now we need to get in detail of the data processing. First, look at human interaction. Humans interact with each other very easily. For us, the natural languages that we use are so convenient that we speak them easily and understand them well too, as these are our mother tongue, so it is very natural for us. But for computer, natural languages are very complex. Why? We have already discussed a lot of complexity in natural languages are problems for computers. What are these complications? These were complicated grammar, means complicated syntax, then multiple meaning words, then perfect syntax but no meaning. So what complications machine can face, we already discussed. Now it is time to see how natural language processing makes it possible for the machine to understand and speak in the natural languages just like human. अब ये देखना है कैसे NLP मशीन को, जो कि नहीं समझ सकता ह्यूमन लैंग्वेज को, नेचुरल लैंग्वेज को, कैसे उसको इनेबल करता है NLP के थ्रू. We know that language of computer is numerical, completely numerical. So what we understand, that first step that come in our mind is convert our language to numbers so that computer can understand that easily. Is it so? Let's go further. The first step we will start data processing is with which we start data processing is text normalization. The first step of text natural language processing is text normalization, and as we know, since human languages are complex, we need to first of all simplify them in order to make sure that understanding becomes possible. Complicated information and heavy loaded textual information, if we will take to the computer, give it to computer, it will be a unsolved work for computer. So first we need to simplify them. As it is, data cannot be used for processing. So text normalization is the first step of natural language processing for cleaning up the textual data. Cleaning up means whatever is not necessary in the textual information to keep its meaning or keep its essence, we need to clean. So that cleaning is required in such a way that it comes down to a level where its complexity is lower than the actual data. So that cleaning is known as text normalization. Let us go further. And yes, this is the definition, text normalization. You have to keep it in mind. Okay, now in text normalization, we undergo several steps to normalize the text to lower level. Ek bar mein nahi hoga, step by step process hai. Before we begin, we need to understand that in this section, as we know that text normalization is not only the textual, means written information, ka normalization hai. Hum uski baat nahi keh rahe hain. But in this context, here in this book or in this syllabus, in this video, in this explanation, I am taking only the example of written text. So we will be working on collection of written text only. And if we are talking about written text, means I am talking about documents. And when we are going to normalize the text, we can have multiple documents. So we need to take the text of those multiple documents and use it all together as single piece of textual information that is known as corpus. Now you can define what the corpus is. The term used for the whole textual data from all the documents altogether is known as corpus. Which type of documents? The documents which we are using for processing. So corpus, this definition also you need to point, keep it in your mind and note it down somewhere. So not only would we go through all the steps of text normalization, we will also try it with few examples using corpus, same corpus. Now the first step was creating the corpus. Okay, now after getting the corpus, we move toward the next step, that is sentence segmentation. The word sentence segmentation is clearly giving the process of it. Under sentence segmentation, the whole corpus is divided into sentences. Each sentence is taken as a different data. So now the whole corpus gets reduced to sentences. Now this is the first conversion. First we have taken multiple documents, merged them as corpus. Now this corpus is divided into sentences. And how you can divide sentences? It's very easy. As we do, when you will see any full stop, then we can see that yes, this is the sentence, ending of the first sentence. Now we will again analyze the next piece of information and get another full stop. Now this is the another sentence. So this way we'll segment sentences, segment corpus to get sentences. Now this first piece of text from the corpus will be considered as sentence 1. Now another one is sentence 2. This way corpus will be converted into sentences. Now the next step is tokenization. After segmenting the sentences, each sentence is then further divided into tokens. As we know, अगर आप एक हाउस समझ लो तो एक हाउस में क्या है, वॉल्स हैं. एंड देन दीज वॉल्स आर बिल्ट विद ब्रिक्स. सो दीज ब्रिक्स आर एक्चुअली टोकन्स. आफ्टर सेगमेंटिंग द सेंटेंसेस, ईच सेंटेंस इज डिवाइडेड फर्दर इनटू टोकन्स. टोकन्स मींस उसके वर्ड्स, नॉट ओनली वर्ड्स, ऑल्सो नंबर्स एंड स्पेशल कैरेक्टर्स. अंडर टोकनाइजेशन एवरी वर्ड, नंबर एंड स्पेशल कैरेक्टर इज कंसिडर्ड सेपरेटली. And each of them is now a separate token. Now you can define token. Here there is a mistake, grammatical mistake. No, remove this as. Token is a term used for any word or number or special character occurring in a sentence. Okay, it's a very simple definition. Token is a term used for any word or number or special character occurring in a sentence. Now sentences are converted into tokens. Now see the example here. After converting the corpus into sentences, we have got this one first sentence. Now in this first sentence, we can see there are words, special characters, and yes, there is no number, but it may be. So these piece of information, single unit information, will be converted into tokens. This in one token, CBT is another token. This comma sign, single comma sign, is an individual token. This way the whole textual information of these sentences will be converted into tokens. So you can see sentences will be converted into tokens. Now the next step, removing stop words, special characters and numbers. Why? After getting tokens, now it is necessary to remove the unnecessary tokens from the token list. Token list mein jo bhi tokens ki zarurat nahi hai, to keep the essence of the information, we need to remove that to normalize the text. Aur simple karna hai. So stop words, what are these stop words? Stop words are the words which occur. First important thing, stop words are actually words, not symbols, not numbers. Stop words are the words which occur very frequently in the corpus but do not add any value to it. Frequently means bahut sare hote hain corpus mein, but do not add any value to it. Uske through, un stop words ke through aap koi meaning nahi nikal sakte sentence. So this is the definition of stop words. It is also very important. Now see, this is the token list which we have converted, which we have got with the previous step. Now in this token list, you can see there are few symbols, but these symbols are not be considered as stop words. Stop words nahi hai. So what are these stop words? What are the words? What are that? What is that list of words which are not necessary for this information? Just think about it. Is the necessary for making the sentence meaningful? Yes, it is necessary for making it grammatically correct. But it is necessary for getting the meaning of the sentence? No. In, to, are, we, on, the, we, in, the means articles, pronouns, prepositions, conjunctions. These are the stop words which are not required in this step to get it simpler form, because these stop words are not giving any meaning to this sentence. Human use grammar, yes, for the we are using these stop words. Why? To make their sentences meaningful for the other person to understand. But grammatically, words do not add any essence to the information which is to be transmitted through the sentence. Hence, they come under stop words. The humans use grammar to make their sentences meaningful for the other person to understand. Without these preposition, conjunction, pronoun, articles, we cannot give the correct structure to our sentences, which anybody else can understand. That's why it is necessary for us. But grammatically, words do not add any essence to the information. So, which is to be transmitted through the sentence. Hence, they come under stop words. Now, we need to remove all these stop words. These words occur the most in any given corpus. सबसे ज़्यादा stop words होते हैं. But talk very little or nothing. But उससे हमारे information, हमारे sentence को कोई खास information नहीं मिलती. Almost कुछ भी नहीं मिलती about the context or the meaning of it. Hence, to make it easier for the computer to focus on meaningful terms only, and these words are removed. All these are stop words which not required in our token list now. Again, we need two more removal. Removing special characters and numbers. Along with the stop words, a lot of times our corpus might have special characters and or numbers like comma, full stop, dash, inverted comma, so exclamation mark. It depends on the type of corpus that we are working on, further we should keep them in or it or not. In some cases, we need these type of information where words are having special characters or numbers like email IDs. If we are having email IDs in our document, then we cannot remove these special characters. So it depends. Then you might not want to remove these special characters and numbers. Whereas in some other textual data, if these words do not make any sense, then you can remove. So we need to remove these special characters and numbers like this. Now next step, converting text to a common case. Okay, abhi starting mein humne jo shuru kiye the, first hum ek bar fir usko recap karte hain, the steps which we have till now completed. In the process of text normalization, we have started with corpus making. We have created corpus, then we done sentence segmentation, then tokenization, and after tokenization, removal of stop words. Then similar case mile aaya. Then the next one was that removal of stop words, numbers, and special characters. Now converting text to a common case. मैंने बीच में बोल दिया, but this step is now coming after removal of stop words, numbers, and special characters. After the stop words removal, we convert the whole text into similar case, preferably lower case. Means if we have tokens, in these tokens they are similar word, means same word will be repeated with different cases. Like it's capital letter means uppercase, it's mixed one, and this is another case. So we can have it in many different type of cases. We need to make it in same form, similar form, and preferably it is lowercase. Why? This step ensures that the case sensitivity of the machine, if the machine is case sensitive, then it does not consider same words as different just because of different cases. That's why we do this step. In this step, the remaining words are reduced. Okay, now the next step is removal of affixes. And for removal of affixes, we can use the process of stemming or the process of lemmatization, which I am discussing after that. So these are the two alternative processes which we can use for removal of affixes of the word. What are affixes? Excuse me. Affixes means suffix or prefix. Any word, any part of the word which is added to its starting at the beginning of the base form of that word is known as prefix. And if any piece of text, any number of characters which are added at the end of the word, base word, is known as suffixes. So these prefixes and suffixes are known as affixes together. So stemming is a process in which the affixes of words are removed and the words are converted to its base form. Base form means the root word from which the word is created. Like car. Car is the root word, but its different forms are cars. Then, okay, sorry, this is the wrong example, because car is a noun. Car can have two words only, car and cars. Yes, cars is the different form of car. Car is the root word. Now, if I am telling you, I can take the example of a study. Study is the base word, root form, but its different forms with affixes are studying, studied, okay. So we need to remove that affixes. And after removing those affixes from the words, we will get stemmed word or stems. The words which we get after removing the affixes in the process of stemming are called stemmed word or stems. There is an example of this token list. See, healed, healing, healer. There are three words in this token list, and these three words are having suffixes, which also known as affixes here. So healed means say aapne ed hataya, we have removed ing from healing, then we have removed er from healer. Now they will convert it into their base form heal. Next example. Two words, studies and studying. These are the tokens which are also having affixes. In first, es will be removed, and in the second word, ing will be removed. And after removing these affixes, we will get two words, two stems. One is study study, and another one is study study, which is morphologically correct as per our dictionary. But study is not in our dictionary, not any such word, because it is not a meaningful word. So we can understand that stemming does not take into account if the stemmed word is meaningful or not. It just removes the affixes, nothing else. Hence it is faster. The alternative of stemming is lemmatization. This is the another process which machines use for removal of affixes. Lemmatization is the alternative process of removal of affixes, but the words we get after lemmatization, known as lemma, will be meaningful. This is the main difference between lemmatization and stemming. Okay, so the lemma means the words which were created after removal of affixes in this step of lemmatization. Those lemma words will be meaningful. So to get the surety that lemma is a word with meaning, it takes a longer time of execution than the process of stemming. And lemma are words which we get after removal of the affixes in the process of lemmatization. This is the definition of lemma. Now the example, see the same example. Now healed, healing, healer, in these three words, affixes were removed, same as we have done in this, that is stemming, and we get the same base word, base form of the word heal. But in studies and studying example, you can see now ES is removed and we get STUDI, but after getting that word, machine refers the dictionary to get it morphologically its correct base form and get the word study as its lemma, not STUDI study. Because studies was created, was developed from the base word study. So, in this step of lemmatization, the morphology of these words will be considered. And the same studying will again be converted into study as lemma. So, in lemmatization, the word we get after affix removal is meaningful one. So, lemma are meaningful, but stems are not necessarily meaningful. Lemmatization makes sure that lemma is a word with meaning, and hence it takes a longer time to execute than time stemming. So this is the second difference. It is lemmatization is slower process, stemming is faster. But lemmatization is giving good result, better result, but stemming is not giving. We can not say that it is giving bad result, because it depends on the necessity requirement of the process. This is the example which clearly differentiate between stemming and lemmatization, which you can use to give the answer in your examination. If we are taking example of caring, in the lemmatization it will give the word care, but in this process of stemming it will give the result car. So you can see that lemmatization will take only the base form which is available in dictionary. And this in the step of stemming, it only removes affixes. Don't think about its meaning. Okay, now I'm stopping my session, and after that I will take one more session on NLP. That will be the last one, the bag of words, which will give the detail of algorithm of that text normalization process. Till then, bye-bye.